So here we go. Thanks everybody for attending this week's. This is number 20, Weekly Hack, and we're going to talk about the importance of extrusion efficiency. And so my name is Max Steele, and today is July 29th, and we welcome you to ask any questions at the end of this. I'm having a little technical difficulty. So here we go. So this is our weekly hack. For those of you who've attended these, you know, we're doing one of these every Wednesday talking about a topic that you might be running into. If you have any questions regarding what we discuss, you can send an email to parts@jcsteele.com. These are also posted at jcsteele.com/weeklyhacks, which will take you into our YouTube channel. So extrusion efficiency first, before we can talk about the benefits, we need to teach you how to calculate it. And so this is a busy slide, we know. But what we want to talk about is there's a simple formula that we use, and we use a displacement based on the auger set you're running. We can help you get that auger set and help you calculate that efficiency. So what you need, in keeping it simple, you need a tape measure, you need a brick slug, you need an exit of your machine, you need a slug cutter, you need a watch. You don't have all those, you got a tachometer, it makes it much easier, but really you need to just have a tape measure and a stopwatch to be able to do what we're about to teach you how to do. Starting out, you need to measure that shaper cap exit. And so really you just need to measure B and D, yeah? And that's gonna give you your column width and your column height. And that's also right on the front of our shaper caps if you're ordering from us, right? We put that on a sticker so you can see that plain and simple. Otherwise, you can get that information at our shaper cap ordering form. If you don't have the ability to measure the front of the cap, or you're doing it while it's running, you can measure your column. We just want you to remember that you need to take into consideration your trimming. So if you're wire cutting that brick or you're scalping that column, make sure that you're accounting for the trimmings that you're shaving off. The other piece, okay, is that you need to understand the void that you're running. Right, and so this comes from your core tip, the number of core tips, and so we have a reference guide that tells you the area of the cores, and roughly you would be able to calculate what that is in relation to your core configuration. So I know this is fast, and what then you're going to divide all of that by your RPMs, and this comes from basically calculating how fast your auger shaft is turning. You can do that by counting the coupling and how many times it rotates. And so once you have all those numbers, you can pause this video and you can look and you can go through and you can say, okay, how's this calculated? Do my numbers come out to show that I'm doing 41% or whatever that percentage is? This is busy, and we know that. And so as we were going through and kind of explaining this, we said, man, how can we simplify that? And so we want to just give you some illustrations, and we're going to come to the end. But you want to make sure that your auger set is full, because a full auger set is going to give you an even push, right? And it's going to give you the most efficient push. And so you want to really just make sure those fast feeds, those back augers, are barely covered with material. And what you'll see is you'll see a flash. And so anyone who's been standing over a vacuum chamber looking down in a machine, you see that flash of auger basically with every rotation. That's indicating that your auger level is pretty much right where you want it. You don't want it too full, and you don't want it too low. You just want to see that light flash. As you see, and these are bad examples of your auger, your material level. So you can see the auger shaft in the picture on the left. On the right, you see material buildup on the pug seal or vacuum chamber wall. That means that you're having vacuum. You're getting material sucked through. It's causing you issues, and it's going to cause you issues as that material comes out of the front of your brake machine. This is the other end of the spectrum. This is 2 hours of work right here digging that thing out. You've run it too full, you're running too slow, and you filled up your vacuum chamber, and so now you're stuck for the next couple hours digging this thing out. So what's probably going on is chances are you have worn wear parts in your machine. And so either you don't have the flexibility through VFDs, variable speed drives, to change your speed to meet the requirements of what you need. So efficiency gives you a real easy way to know what's the life of your wear parts inside of your machine without having to open up and get in there. So what is the optimum run rate for my machine, for the materials? It changes on materials, it changes on product, but the easiest way is you stop your pug sealer, you fill your vacuum chamber, or you stop your extruder, you fill your vacuum chamber, and then you do the same steps as above. You measure that column speed and you see, okay, at a full auger set, this is my column speed. You take that number of what a full auger set is, and you divide it by the RPMs that you know you're running, and it gives you your feet per revolution, and then you divide that by your actual production rate, and it'll give you the actual RPM you should be running your machine. So once you've determined what your RPMs are, you're going to recognize that you're going to be able to save some money, you're going to improve the quality of your product. And when I was looking for an image of a breakdown, it gave me this picture of the woman. So she's having a breakdown. We're talking about machinery breakdowns, but it's going to reduce your stress, right? And that's really what we're after, is improving quality, saving some money, and reducing your stress. It's going to give you less auger wear, because the slower you turn that machine with the same output means you less heat. You know, you're going to have lower column temperature, you're going to have a better column, and you're going to have a more consistent column speed, so that you're not interrupting that setter that's downstream. And it's going to improve the overall bearing and wear life of your machines. So how do you change speed? Either with a VFD or a pulley change. And we can help you with either one of those. Just contact one of us and we'd be happy to come out, do an efficiency test, walk through what we can do to help you optimize the speed of your machine. We're also in the process of putting an efficiency calculator on our website right there, where your operator can go on with his smartphone, key in the information, and calculate an efficiency real time. We have this calculator also in Excel that we can provide you if you'd like it. So contact us. We're here. You got my phone number. If you're calling me, it's the wrong person. Call Steve, call Jimmy, call George, either one, call Wayne, call Adam in Australia, call us, let us come out there, do an efficiency test for you and get you going. And any clay need that you have, we can handle it either through Steele, Handler, Durexa, Brown. We touch clay day in, day out. It's what we do, and we want to help you. So open it up to any questions, and otherwise we thank you for this time.